Richard and Sam lived in a town called Canterville with their mother. Their mother earned the living after their father's death. They were very poor and so she could not give them new clothes. But she always taught them good lesson. Both of her sons were very sensible. They never let her feel lonely. One day, Sam and Richard thought,
"Hey Sam, our mother works so hard for us. Can't we do anything for her?"
"Yes, Richard, this thought has come to my mind many times.
So, what can we do for our mother?"
"We can do some work and earn some money."
"This is a good idea. We will do that to give our mother some happiness."
"Yes, come, let us look for some work."
Sam and Richard found a job of distributing newspapers. Both of them went to distribute newspapers in the house every morning. They bought a sari from that money.
"Mom, I bought a sari for you. Both of us brought this for you."
"Mom, did you like the sari? We bought this from our income."
"Oh, when did you buy all this? And what was the need for this?"
"Hey Mom, there was a need for this. You do so much for us."
"Hey Mom, we have done nothing for you. Just a small thing."
"Both of you are world's best kid. You are mine by God's grace." Saying this, her mother hugged Richard and Sam and then went to do her work. Now Sam and Richard studied hard and they achieved good marks in their exams. And so their mother was very happy with them. Now both grew up. They got a good job in company and they worked sincerely. Their mother did not end to work. One day, Richard and Sam told their mother,
"Mom, you no longer need to work. Please leave your job."
Both of them said the same thing. And their mother told them, "Hey kids, you thought for me and that is great. I don't need anything more. Now, don't think about me much. You need to think about yourself and what would you like to do in future." Saying this, Mom went from there and Richard and Sam started thinking about themselves, that what Mom wanted to say. After a few days, Richard and Sam married girls with good families. After their marriage, the entire family started living together in the same house. Now the wives of Richard and Sam fought with their husband for some of the other reason. Richard's wife was Shelley and Sam's wife was Sonia. Both of them lived together nicely, but they did not do any of their mother's work. After the marriage of their sons, her sons had said,
"Hey Mom, now your daughter-in-laws have come. You don't need to do anything."
"Yes, son. Now I am relaxed. I have no worries left." That is why mother didn't work. But seeing this, both the daughter-in-laws felt really jealous and so did not talk to their mother-in-law properly. That's why they always complained about Mom in front of their husbands. Shelley told Richard,
"Hey, listen, your mom doesn't do any work. If we ask her to take care of kids, she says, 'My children have asked me not to do work.' Saying this, she ignores."
"Hey, what are you saying, dear? We told Mom just for the sake of saying, but perhaps she took it to her heart. Come on, let it go."
On the other hand, Sam was facing the same problem. His wife was also complaining. Sonia said,
"Hey, Mom doesn't do any work, but is always enjoying on your money."
"Yes, you are right. We will have to do something about her."
Thinking this, one day Sam and Richard were chit-chatting with each other. And when they happened to talk about mother, then Sam said,
"Hey Richard, now it has become impossible to handle Mom. Why don't we send our mom to some old age home? This will keep us happy and our wives will also remain stress-free."
"Yes bro, this is a good idea. We will do this."
Now both the brothers are very happy. Now there's nothing to worry about. Both of them goes to the bed with the same thought. Their kids were listening all this and they didn't like it. They went to their grandmother and told her everything.
"Grandmother, Daddy and Mom are planning to send you to old age home."
"What are you saying, son?"
"Grandmother, I have a great plan. I will tell you that. You do as I say."
"Okay, son. I will do as you say."
"Grandmother, Tomorrow I will bring a trunk for you and you put some fake property papers in it. Tell everyone at home that my husband had left these in my name.
Okay, son. Kids bought a big trunk at night and said,
Grandmother, this is a big trunk. You put some property papers in this tomorrow. They will make them believe that you have at least some money left. Then they will take care of you at home and we will be able to live with you.
Yes, my children. I also want to live with you. You don't worry. At least because of you, I can live with my family. I don't need anything else in life. Children hugged their grandmother dearly and they and their grandmother went to sleep. The other day, grandmother did exactly as she was told to do by her grandchildren. Richard and Sam was not able to understand what was the matter. Both of them looked to each other and had a weird feeling. Son, I'm not going to live long now. I thought I should tell you. All that your father had left, 50 acres of land in my name. And he had said, the one who look after me after his death will get the property. After listening to this, Rob and Steen were amazed and think in their minds. Rob tells Steen,
Hey, our mother has such a pricey land. Did you know anything about this?
No, bro. I had no idea about this.
Now, Richard and Sam started taking care of their mother properly. And the two daughter-in-laws also took very good care. And they were very happy. And children were also happy as they could live with their grandmother more. Children told grandmother,
Look, how nicely everyone is behaving with you. Now you don't have to worry at all.
Yes, my child. I want nothing more. I'm able to live with you all. That's what I wanted. After listening to what kids had to say, grandmother became very happy and she hugged the kids and said, Son, only because of you I'm able to live in this house and have been well taken care of also. Now grandmother, their sons and grandchildren all lived together in the house happily. This story teaches us that we should always respect our elders. They are important to us always.
There lived a man named James in a village, Muratok. He used to work in others' fields to earn his living. His wife Stella and his son Robert lived in his family. They were poor but very happy in their life. They used to work hard to earn.
Hey Stella, please serve the food fast. I have to go to work early tomorrow.
Yeah, sure. Just 5 minutes more. After a while, Stella serves the meal and everyone sleeps after eating. Hey, why do you have to go early tomorrow?
Dear, tomorrow there is a lot of work to do on the field, so I'll go there early.
Okay.
Now stop talking and go to sleep.
The next day, James got to the field before sunrise and starts working. Working, it got evening and dark. James was about to leave the field when he suddenly stepped on a snake and the snake bit James. James started shouting loudly. Since it was evening, everyone was indoors after getting back from their fields and so nobody could hear James shouting. After some time, James fell unconscious. Next day, few people came to the field and they saw James lying unconscious in the field.
Let's go and check.
Villagers go near James.
Hey James bro, get up. What happened to you?
But James didn't get up. Then one man looks at his feet.
James bro was bitten by a snake. See the marks on the foot.
Everyone takes James to his home.
Oh, what happened to my husband? Why did you all bring him in this way?
Then one man tells the fact to Stella. Listening to all this, Stella felt the ground slipping under her feet.
Oh my God! What did you do? What will I do now? How will I feed my family?
Stella started crying. Now the house responsibility was completely on Stella. Now Stella started working in the fields and earned her living. Few years passed. Now Robert started to go to school.
Ma, please give me my tiffin fast. I'm getting late to school.
Yes, my son. I'm bringing it.
Stella brings the tiffin and hands it to Robert. Time passed. Robert started to go to college. He never felt sorry for his mother's condition and he had become irresponsible.
Hey friends,
Why not we go for a picnic tomorrow?
Yeah, sure. We will have lots of fun.
Saying this, all his friends go home and Robert sits there thinking.
I have agreed to go to the picnic. But from where I'll get the money?
Robert, immersed in this thought, comes home and tells his mother.
Ma, I need 5,000 rupees tomorrow.
Hey son, why do you need so much money? And I don't have that much money, son.
Ma, I don't know anything. You do anything, but give me money till evening, otherwise I will not come home.
Hey son, don't do this. I really don't have that much money with me.
Ma, do anything. I want the money at any cost.
Okay, my son, I will do something. Stella gets worried on how to get so much money. She goes to the owner of her field and asks for half of the money as loan. But even then there was shortage of money. Now Stella goes to her neighbor and asks for some loan. And anyhow she gathers 5,000 rupees.
Ma, give me the money, fast.
Yes, my dear son, I will give it to you right now. Stella gives the money to Robert. Both of them go to sleep after having dinner. The other day, Robert leaves with his friends for picnic. Son, be careful and keep your money safe.
Yes, Ma. I'm not a small kid now.
Robert leaves home and all the friends catch the bus to go to picnic. Robert looks at a girl in the bus and he likes her. Robert starts talking to her.
Hi, I'm Robert. What's your name?
I'm Grace.
After talking to her, he starts loving her. But Grace was a very angry girl. After getting back from picnic, Robert brings Grace his home.
Ma, see who is with me.
Who is she, son?
Stella looks at Grace, but Grace was looking at her angrily. After staying for a while, Grace leaves their house.
Ma, did you like Grace? I'm going to marry her.
Son, I do not think this girl is good for you. You will find a far better one.
You don't teach me. If I ever get married, it will be with Grace.
Okay, son, as you wish. You have to spend your life with her. If both of you stay happy, why would anything bother me?
After a few days, Robert and Grace got married. One day, Grace started arguing with her mother-in-law.
I will not do any work. If you want to do, you can do. Otherwise, leave it.
Oh dear, but when I will not be here, you will have to do everything.
I will see then. Don't try to teach me.
In the evening, when Robert comes home,
hey, look, your mother doesn't work at all and makes me to do everything and argues with me on the top of that.
Robert goes and abuses his mother. Grace becomes happy after seeing all this. Now this became routine. Grace used to provoke Robert against his mother, keeping Robert away from his mother. One day, she burnt her hand by herself. And in the evening, when Robert came home,
hey, see what your mother did today. I refused to work and so your mother burnt my hand.
After listening to Grace, Robert got very angry. He threw his mother out of the house.
Son, what have I done that you are throwing me out of the house? Where will I go at this age? Think about your old mother, please. Don't do this, son.
Stop crying and get out of my house.
Poor Stella takes her stuff and leaves the house. She starts living in a temple nearby. Time passes by. One day, suddenly Robert feels pain in his heart.
Hey Grace, I'm having a pain in my heart. Please take me to the hospital.
Grace takes Robert to the hospital. Doctors check Robert and tell Grace,
look madam, there is a hole in your husband's heart. We will have to find a person by tomorrow who would be ready to give his heart to him. Otherwise, we will not be able to save your husband.
Hearing this from the doctor, Grace gets terrified. She doesn't understand what to do. Robert's neighbor finds this out and she tells this to Robert's mother. As soon as Robert's mother comes to know this, she comes to the hospital immediately and talks to the doctor.
Doctor, please save my child. You can take my heart, but please save my son's life.
Stella gives her heart to her son and says goodbye to this world for her son. Robert's operation was successful. The other day when Robert gains consciousness, he asks Grace,
hey Grace, what happened to me?
Before Grace could say anything, doctors come there.
Robert, Your operation has been quite successful. You need not to worry at all.
But doctor, what had happened to me?
You had a hole in your heart. Your mother gave her life to save yours.
Hearing this, Robert and Grace had tears in their eyes. Robert started crying.
What? My mother gave me her heart.
Yes, Robert. Your mother gave her heart to you. And now she is no more.
After listening to the doctor, Robert was dumbfounded. Grace also feels ashamed of what she did. Right then, Robert puts his hand on his heart and he heard a voice.
My son, I did everything for you, but you never cared for me. But son, I told you, I will never let you fall short of anything. That's it. I kept my promise. You stay happy, my son.
Listening to this, Robert started crying, but there was no use being restless. Robert's life was saved, but his mother was not with him anymore. Friends, a mother can do anything for her children. There is no one greater than a mother in this world. Those who are fortunate to have the love of both mother and father, they are the richest and fortunate people in the world. Always respect your mother and father.
You idiot! Does it take so long to fetch water? There are clothes to wash, utensils to clean. Who is going to do that?
I will do it right away, Mom.
Don't you dare call me Mom. You killed your own mother during birth, and now you wish to kill me too? Oh, Stacy dear, you got up early. Are you not feeling well?
Yes, Mom. I'm just feeling hungry. Give me something to eat.
Oh my God. See, my darling is hungry. And this witch has not even cooked food yet. Now are you going to stare at me or will you cook food now?
I will cook right away, Mom.
Mom, today I wish like eating fish.
Oh yes, dear. Today for you we will cook fish. Hey, Anna. Did you hear that? My daughter wants to eat fish today. Go and catch some fresh fish from the river.
Yes, I'm going. Today I'm unable to find a single fish. What shall I do? Mom, I miss you a lot. Why did you leave me? Am I so bad? Speak up, Mom. Oh, my ring. This is my mother's only thing left. Give me back my ring.
What kind of tunnel is this? What is this?
Help! Help! My children! There's fire! Fire! Someone save my children! They will die! Help! My children! My little children! They are trapped in fire! Somebody save them! Please save them! Dear, can you save them? Please help me!
Don't worry, O bird. I'll rescue them.
Very grateful to you, dear. You may proceed on this road ahead.
How come? How is the water of this river drying up? Oh, so you are here. That ring is my mother's last thing I have. Give it to me back right now.
You catch us and kill us every day. You are very bad. I will not give you the ring back.
I'm helpless. I have to do that because my stepmother asked me to do that.
Okay, I will give you the ring back. But you will have to do something for that. There lives a witch on that hill. She is drying up the water of this river with her black magic. If this continues, This river will dry up soon and we will be killed. You will have to stop the witch somehow and end this black magic.
Okay, I will do that for you. But you will have to promise me one thing. If I succeed in stopping that witch, you will give me back my ring. Deal?
Yes, of course. I promise you.
Once all the water of this river dries up, I will eat the fish out there. Then I will not have to catch fish.
Huh? You should go away from here. This witch is wicked. She has trapped me in this cage. She will catch you too. Go away! Go away!
Huh?
Run away! I've opened your cage.
No, I'm afraid to go out. The witch will catch me again. I will stay here itself.
Well then, in that case, I will have to save you from the witch.
Huh? Who are you? What are you doing here?
You should stop your black magic now. This is drying up the river and all the fishes are dying. Please don't do this.
Interesting. I will eat all the fish out there. I am tired of catching the fish, and that is why I am drying up the river.
You should not do this. Don't do this.
Oh, who are you to stop me? Now I will turn you into a fish and eat you. Okay, now I will bring some spices from the market. Then I will cook you and eat up.
Listen, Parrot, I need your help. If you don't show courage today, then we will not be able to get rid of this witch forever.
You are a very brave and good girl. I will help you. Take this. Keep this magic wand with you. With its help, you can teach a good lesson to the witch.
Who brought you back to original?
That he will tell you.
You catch people and imprison them. Now we will make you pay for this.
Why are you doing this? I only wanted to eat fish.
You were getting fish as per your need, but you are greedy and wanted to eat all of them. There is a big difference between greed and need. You are harming others for your greed and benefit.
Forgive me, I was blinded by greed. You are right, I should take things as per my need. Forgive me, I will stop my black magic and I will not kill any fish from today. You opened my eyes, dear.
Thank you so much, Anna. You are really very sweet and good child. You saved us all. Even the nest of that bird and this parrot also.
Huh? But how do you know this?
I know everything.
I was just testing you. Now I want you to give something, after which you will never have to catch fish again. Of gold?
Yes, because you deserve this. Because your heart is more valuable than this gold. And here, take your mother's ring.
Thank you. I will be grateful to you forever. Thank you so much.
Oh, what is this? Huh? So much gold? Where did you get this? Oh, wow. Then we two will also go and bring lots of gold. And till then, you must keep food ready. Wow, this is really a very nice place. Now we will take lots of gold from here.
Please help me. Save my children. Save my nest.
Are you out of your mind? Why should we risk our lives to save your nest?
And what if something happens to us? Come on, Mom, let's go fast. We have come here to get gold.
This seems to be the same fish. Come, let's ask for gold. Hey you, fish, were you the one who gave gold to my Anna?
Are you her mother?
Yes, I'm her mother. Now give us that gold too.
Yes, I'll give it now.
Oh, how did this happen? How did we become frogs?
That is because both of you are lazy, slothful, and greedy. You are Anna's stepmother. Both of you have treated her very badly. This is a punishment for that.
No, no. Please forgive us. We will never treat her badly now. And we don't even need gold. Please make us as before. We will fix our mistakes.
Now go and live happily together. This is for your own benefit.
Please forgive us, dear. We have hurt you a lot. We are ashamed of our deeds. Please forgive us.
Oh, Mother.